We humans have a long and fiery history. Since our early ancestors first tamed the flame, fire has been a constant companion, a tool, and a symbol of progress. It's warmed us, lit our way, cooked our food, and powered our industries. But what if I told you that this ancient technology might be the key to unlocking our future among the stars, and even explain why we haven't encountered alien life yet? Today we're exploring the rare fire solution to the Fermi Paradox. Are we alone in the universe, or is there more to the story? Let's find out together. At the very core of human civilization lies a discovery that has shaped our existence: fire. Its significance extends far beyond the warmth it provides or the food it cooks. Fire has been instrumental in everything from forging metals to generating energy. It enabled us to adapt to colder climates, fend off predators, and eventually build societies. From the earliest blacksmiths fashioning tools to the steam engines propelling the Industrial Revolution, fire has been the catalyst of our technological progress. But do we truly comprehend its full potential? And why does this matter in our quest for extraterrestrial life? The ability to harness fire is a unique trait intricately tied to specific environmental and biological conditions that may not be prevalent on other celestial bodies. Hang on a sec, guys, before we continue. Be sure to join the Insane Curiosity channel. Click on the bell, you'll help us to make products of even higher quality. The discovery of fire was a game changer for the fate of humanity, but it required something like oxygen. Oxygen is not just essential for life, it's crucial for fire. Earth's atmosphere reached its current oxygen-rich state through billions of years of photosynthesis, primarily by plants and algae. This process transformed the planet and set the stage for fire development. Oxygen supports combustion, which is vital for technological advances from cooking food to smelting metals. However, the presence of oxygen at the right concentration is rare. If extraterrestrial environments lack similar evolutionary paths, they might not have fire, limiting potential technological advancements. This rarity of breathable, oxygen-rich atmospheres may be a critical factor in the Fermi Paradox, a concept that ponders why, given the vast number of stars and potential for life in the universe, we haven't yet seen any signs of extraterrestrial civilizations. It suggests that the conditions necessary for the development of fire, and by extension, advanced technology, might be exceptionally uncommon in the universe. The Carboniferous period, a crucial era for life on Earth, was characterized by extremely high levels of oxygen, up to 35%, compared to today's 21%. This oxygen-rich atmosphere led to frequent and large-scale wildfires, profoundly influencing the evolution of Earth's flora and fauna. The dense forests of the period provided ample fuel, while high oxygen levels made the environment particularly prone to combustion. This period showcases a delicate ecological balance, where too much oxygen could lead to destructive wildfires, yet it was also a time when the foundations for complex ecosystems were laid. Such conditions could be exceedingly rare on other planets, making Earth-like fire-dependent technological evolution unique in the cosmos. These segments of Earth's history highlight the unique conditions that have supported life and technology on our planet, and underscore the potential rarity of such conditions elsewhere in the universe. This could be a pivotal reason behind the Fermi Paradox, suggesting that civilizations capable of using fire and thus developing technology that could signal their existence to us might be exceptionally uncommon. The impact of fire on our technological progress is nothing short of profound. It's not just about warmth and cooking. Fire enabled early human societies to manipulate their environment in revolutionary ways. By harnessing fire, our ancestors could clear vast tracts of land for agriculture, fundamentally altering ecosystems to better suit agricultural practices. Moreover, the ability to smelt metal transformed societies, leading to the development of tools, weapons, and eventually machinery. This mastery of fire accelerated the advancement of engineering and science, laying the groundwork for modern technology. Without fire, the Industrial Revolution, powered by steam engines that relied heavily on combustion, would have been unimaginable. Thus, fire is not merely a tool, but a foundational element that catalyzed the rise of civilization as we know it. Its role in our history is a testament to its power and significance. But what about exoplanets covered with oceans? Can't life just thrive in the oceans in the absence of fire? Considering life on water-covered planets, the absence of fire poses significant barriers to technological advancement. In aquatic environments, even if intelligent life evolves, such as the sophisticated but arm-limited dolphins or the dexterous octopuses, the mastery of fire remains unachievable. Water inhibits the generation of fire by preventing the accumulation of sufficient heat, which is essential for combustion. This limitation restricts the ability to process materials like metals, which are pivotal in advancing from simple tool use to complex machinery. Consequently, civilizations in aquatic settings might develop along entirely different lines, possibly focusing on biotechnology or other forms of technology that don't rely on heat and combustion. This divergence in technological evolution once again highlights how pivotal fire has been on Earth. It suggests that the absence of fire could lead to a very different path of technological development on other planets. Considering all these factors, the rarer fire solution suggests that the conditions needed to harness fire are so specific and rare that very few planets might ever reach this stage. Thus, while the universe might be teeming with life, technologically advanced civilizations capable of making themselves known across the cosmos might be extraordinarily rare. This concept suggests that the ability to harness fire, a unique trait intricately tied to specific environmental and biological conditions, might be a crucial factor in the development of advanced civilizations. If the conditions necessary for the development of fire, and by extension, advanced technology, are exceptionally rare in the universe, it could explain why we haven't yet seen any signs of extraterrestrial civilizations. So, fire, as a critical milestone in technological development, may be more unique to Earth than previously assumed, providing a compelling answer to the Fermi Paradox. The rarity of fire hinges on several stringent conditions. A planet must have sufficient oxygen, which itself depends on specific biological geological histories. It must have flammable materials, which are biological products. And it must have the climatic and environmental conditions that allow fire to catch and spread without extinguishing life. These conditions are so specific that they may seldom coincide in the universe, making Earth an extraordinary exception rather than the rule. On planets where these conditions do not align, the development of technology as we understand it, relying on heat, combustion, and metallurgy, could be severely limited or take a completely different path that might not produce detectable signals like radio waves or visible lights across vast interstellar distances. Thus, fire's rarity could fundamentally limit the emergence of technologically advanced civilizations capable of making contact or being detected by us, thereby offering a solution to why we find ourselves seemingly alone despite the vastness of the universe and its billions of stars and planets. This perspective encourages us to rethink our search strategies and assumptions about what forms a technological civilization can take. So fire, and the mere discovery of fire, could be a critical factor in determining the advancement of civilizations. However, let's not limit our imagination to just fire. Civilizations could potentially evolve using alternative energy sources like geothermal or tidal energy. The challenge remains whether such alternatives could support an advanced, industrialized civilization capable of space exploration or emitting detectable signals. Geothermal energy, for instance, exploits planetary heat and could be particularly accessible on volcanically active worlds. Tidal power harnesses the kinetic energy of water bodies, ideal for water-rich planets. Solar technology might involve ultra-efficient photovoltaic systems or artificial photosynthesis, mimicking or enhancing natural processes to create sustainable energy sources. Furthermore, biochemical processes could lead to unique bioenergetic technologies, where organisms convert organic materials directly into usable power. Finally, electromagnetic energy from natural planetary fields could offer another untapped resource, suggesting that civilizations might exploit these forces directly to power their societies. Each energy source could lead to distinct technological advancements, potentially unseen and undetectable by our current methods, emphasizing the diversity of possible evolutionary pathways in the cosmos. It would then follow that SETI and other alien hunting strategies would be under some pressure to reconsider their game. We shouldn't be looking out for fire signals or other traditional signs and markers of technology. Rather, we should look for non-fire-based markers of civilization, or better still, for something totally different. This may involve the development of new sensors and instruments that can detect such alternative energy uses. For example, sensing weird electromagnetic patterns or other atypical chemical signatures in atmospheres. Reformulating our frameworks to include those civilizations that can, from radically different technological paradigms, find a way for progress could open new lines of discovery. All of this broadens the search criteria, making it more likely that we would find a civilization with characteristics significantly different from our own. So what do you think? Does the rare fire solution provide a compelling answer to the Fermi paradox? Or are we just beginning to scratch the surface of what's possible in the vast universe? As we continue to explore and understand our place in the cosmos, each hypothesis brings us closer to answering the tantalizing question, are we alone? Always remember that this universe is a pretty big place with lots and lots of stuff, at least for now, way beyond our understanding. So keep looking up, remain curious, and who knows, one day we might find that we're not so alone in the universe after all. Thanks for watching, and until next time, ponder the mysteries of the cosmos.